are you feeling? Yeah, you do look like you're doing a little bit better, but I can still see that you're sweating and hot. Do you mind if I just quickly check?
Okay.
Come here. Just check your face and... yeah, you definitely still have a fever. Let me take your temperature, okay? We're gonna put this under your arm. Mm-hmm. Right here. I'll just give that a few minutes. You've been sleeping all day. That's good. You've been having nightmares. I'm sorry. I know when you're sick and you have a fever, it's so common to have all these vivid dreams and nightmares. But I'm here. And I even put up a dream catcher for you so that I can hopefully capture some of the nightmares. Okay. Alright. Are you comfortable sitting up like that? I have some more pillows for you. Here. Let's put that behind you. I know you've been in so much pain. All the aches and chills and... but it's a good thing. It's getting your temperature up, getting your immune system working, your neutrophils and macrophages and... T-cells and B-cells, they're all working so hard to fight the infection, okay? You're doing really well. Here, let's bundle you up so you don't get cold. You feel quite warm? Well, let's keep you warm, okay? There you go. All right. Let me check your temperature. Okay. 38.5 degrees Celsius. It's on the higher end of a low-grade fever. Got some water here. And I can use it to just sort of give some symptomatic relief. And wipe off all the sweat, okay? Here we go. Yes, we are. I know. Been so hard for you. There you are, my love. It's okay. Swipe off your neck a little bit. Okay. Good. I know you haven't been eating much, but it's important that you eat, okay? I just just made some rice porridge for you. It's, the flavor is not that intense. I just added a little bit of garlic, ginger, sun-dried tomatoes, and a little bit of salt. And I have some salt and pepper if you want to add some more. Okay, but overall it's very bland, very easy to digest. Just a little bit of extra energy to keep you going. Okay. I know you have very little energy right now, so don't worry. I'll feed you. It is a little hot though. Let me know if you want more salt and pepper, okay? I know you haven't been having much of a sense of taste, but I still want it to be as palatable for you as possible. Okay, it's hot, so I'm just going to blow on it. Let's get a few more spoons, okay? Good, good, good. There you are. Can you have one more? And I have here a cup of tea. It's nice and warm. Lemon, ginger, and manuka honey with some extra raw honeycomb. And let's add a little bit of lemon in there because I know you like that. Here you are, let's drink some up. Very good. Alright. You need to make sure you replenish your fluids because you're losing a lot of it through your sweat, and also the immune system really needs a lot of hydration in order to continue doing what it's doing in terms of creating enough energy in your body, enough ATP, and just keeping everything moving, your blood, your lymph, okay, and your kidney function, just everything. So let's drink some more. Here you go, very good. I also brought some walnuts. Would you like some? Do you want to have one? Okay. We call it yangak. So full of many trace minerals and healthy fats, as well as fiber. I know it's your favorite treat, so here you go. Good. One more. It's been so hard for you. You just can't seem to catch a break, can you? You've been under so much stress. What can I do to help you? I thought you'd never ask. You want a bedtime story? Of course, of course. As you know, sleeping is so important for fighting this infection. You really need to save up all your energy in order to let your body do the work that it's doing. Okay, my love? Alright. Your favorite book. Okay. Now, which story would you like me to read today? You can read about the peach boy Momotaro. I know, classic story. Or we could, what about the magic tea kettle? What do you think? Choose the story? Of course. Can you see it properly? Okay. Alright, are you ready? Okay. The long-nosed goblins. Long ago, there were two long-nosed goblins who lived in the high mountains of northern Japan. One was a green goblin, and the other a red goblin. They were both very proud of their noses, which they could extend for many, many leagues across the land. And they were always arguing as to who had the most beautiful nose. One day, the green goblin was resting on top of his mountain when he smelled something very good coming from somewhere down on the plain. "My, but something smells good," he said. "I wonder what it is." So he started extending his nose, making it grow longer and longer as it followed the smell. His nose grew so long that it crossed seven mountains, went down into the plains, and finally ended up at a great mansion. Inside the mansion, the lord's young daughter, Princess White Flower, was having a party. Many princesses had come to the party, and Princess White Flower was showing them her rare and beautiful robes. They had opened the treasure house and taken out the wonderful clothes, all packed in incense. It was the incense that the green goblin had smelled. Princess Whiteflower was looking for a place to hang her robes so that everyone could see them better. When When she caught sight of the green goblin's nose, she said, "Oh, look, someone's hung a green pole here. We'll hang the ropes on it." So the princess called her maids, and they hung the beautiful robes on the goblin's nose. The green goblin, sitting far away on his mountain, felt something tickling his nose, so he began to pull it back in. When the princesses saw the beautiful robes flying away from the air, they were very surprised. They tried to take back the robes, but they were too late. The green goblin was very pleased when he saw the beautiful robes hanging from his nose. He gathered them up and took them home with him. Then he invited the red goblin, who lived on the next mountain, to come and see him. So you can see, the green goblin on the mountain with his lovely nose extended as far as possible with the great lord's daughter's lovely clothes all on it. And he reeled it back in, of course. "Just look what a wonderful nose I have," he said to the red goblin. "It's brought me all these wonderful robes." The red goblin was jealous when he saw the robes. He would have turned green with envy, except that red goblins can't turn green. "I'll show you whose nose is best," the red goblin said. "Just you wait, and I'll show you." And so the red goblin sat on top of his mountain every day, rubbing his long red nose and sniffing the air. Many days passed, and he still hadn't smelled anything good. He became very impatient and said, "Well, I won't wait any longer. I'll send my nose down to the plains anyway, and it's sure to find something good there." So the red goblin started extending his nose, making it grow longer and longer until it crossed 7 mountains, went down into the plains, and finally ended up at the same lord's mansion. Whew, imagine having such a long nose. That'll be really tiring on the neck. At that moment, the lord's young son, Prince Valoris, and his little friends were playing in the garden. When Prince Valoris caught sight of the red goblin's nose, he cried, "Look at this red pole that someone's put here. Let's use it as a swing." So the children tied some ropes to the red pole to make swings. Then how they played! They swung high up into the sky and climbed all over the red pole. One boy even cut his name into the pole with a knife. How this hurt the red goblin sitting back on his mountain. His nose was so heavy that he couldn't pull back. But when his nose got cut, the red goblin shook the children off with all his might and pulled it back to his mountain as fast as he could. The green goblin laughed and laughed at the sight. The red goblin only sat stroking his nose and said, "This is what I get for being jealous. I'm never going to send my nose down into the plains again." That's the end of that story. How is it? You like it?
Alright.
I know, it's getting late. How are you feeling, my love? Yeah. Eggs are back. I know. Oh, I wish I could take away all your pain. I'm so sorry you have to go through all this pain. I promise I'm here to take care of you, okay? What do you need? Okay, of course. You want me to sing you a song? Sure. What song would you like? Now, are Are you all cozy? Just want to make sure you're all bundled up. Okay. You're not shivering as much anymore, so that's good. Okay. Close your eyes, my love. Close your eyes. There's nothing that you have to worry about at all at this moment except resting, okay? Rest. Nothing at all for you to worry about. Do you want a little bit more tea? Of course. Here you go. Good. You know, I love you very much. Always. I'm here for you. Okay. Quietly hush now to sleep on the wings of a butterfly. Let all your cares drift. Whenever I'm frightened, when I've ever felt alone, I look to the night sky and the star I call my home. Somewhere I can run to, just across the Milky Way. Feel like I could take you. It's just a light year and a day. We can sail away tonight on a sea of pure moonlight. We can navigate the stars to bring us back home. In a place so far away, we'll be young, that's how we'll stay. Every wish is a command when you find yourself in never, never land. Picture a land that you never have seen, a light that is perfect and evergreen, future of happiness all in your hands, all in this place of your dreams, here inside Neverland. We can sail away tonight to bring us back home in a place so far away. We'll be young, that's how we'll stay. And with your hand in my hand, we are close enough to finding Neverland. I wish you the sweetest dreams, my love, because you deserve it so much. So much. You've been working so hard. And I feel for you. I really wish I could take away all your stress and all your pain. But I will comfort you forever. I promise. You're going to be okay. Give you a kiss. Sweet dreams, okay? I'll see you in the morning.